Hello everyone! As you know, the VSDC 9.3 update has arrived, and we've seen that the text conversion tool quickly became a fan favorite. Today we will dive into how to make the most of it and create incredible text effects. So grab a cozy spot and let's get started. First, add your text to the scene using the vertical left panel. Customizing the text appearance at this stage is essential, because after conversion, any changes made to the original text layer won't apply to the converted objects. If you need to make adjustments, you'll have to undo the conversion using the green back arrow above the scene and then reconvert the text. Next, right-click on the text object, ensuring there is no blinking cursor by pressing Escape if needed, and hover over Convert Text To. You'll see four modes available for transforming your text. Let's select the first one, Free Shape, and see a settings window for it. The Split By parameter controls how many free shapes should appear on the scene. When you click on the arrow next to it, you'll find different ways to split your text. For example, if you select Characters, each letter of your text object becomes an individual free shape. Similarly, selecting words or sentences will split the text into free shapes based on the number of words or sentences respectively. Choosing None will keep all your text in a single free shape. The next parameter, Fade In, determines how these free shapes appear relative to one another. Here you'll find several options, each creating a unique effect. Let's take a look at the differences between them. For our example, we set the Split By parameter to words, Fade In to 1x1, and Fade In Duration to 2000 milliseconds, meaning our text will appear on the scene split by words, 1x1, within 2 seconds. The fade-in overlap controls the timing shift for the entire animation. In this example, we will set it to 0, since we want a smooth text appearance without any time delay at the beginning. The fade-out settings work similarly to fade-in, but they affect how the shapes disappear. Once you've configured the fade-in and fade-out options as you need, you'll notice that the fade-in and fade-out effects on the right side of the window become available. Here you can choose from various transition styles for text appearance and disappearance. Explore these options to see lots of different looks you can achieve for your text animation. We'll show you a few examples of the effects we created with them. But that is not the only benefit of converting text to free shapes. Now we have access to all the options available specifically to them. For example, you can adjust the shape of individual letters, modify the fill color using gradients or dot gradient for a custom look. Look at some more animations made possible by converting text to free shapes. If you're new to working with free shapes, we have a detailed tutorial on our channel. Just click on the card in the top right corner to watch it. Let's move on to the next type of conversion, Curve Line. This mode works similarly to the free shape mode, but with a few differences. The first difference is that we can choose to use all contours or choose from even and odd as separations. You can select your preferable option in the mode parameter of the conversion settings window. The second difference is that we can set the fade-in and fade-out effects only to duration. In result, we have here the effect of drawing the text contour. The fade-in effect duration parameter controls the time during which our text should appear on the scene. The fade-out effect duration works similarly, but it controls the text disappearance. As a result, we get a ready animation of the letter's outline appearance. As with the free shapes, after the conversion, we can change the converted objects using the settings available exactly for this mode. For curved lines, we can change, for instance, their thickness, color of the contour, and other parameters. By experimenting with the properties window, you can achieve great results. The third conversion type is tracking points. We want to show you two animations you can create with this mode. Our first example is similar to the animation shown in the release video, where the contour appears as if drawn by a pencil. To achieve this, set mode to both, fade in to 1x1, and effect to none. Next, add a PNG image of a pencil with a transparent background and convert it into a sprite by right-clicking on it on the timeline and selecting Convert to Sprite. After that, double-click on the tracking point closest to the left edge on the timeline, copy the movement layer and paste it into the sprite. To apply this effect across all text, repeat these steps for each tracking point. Now we need to convert the text the second time, but to curved lines, keeping the same durations, and manually synchronize the animation so that the line draws as the pencil moves. To do this, select the first curved line, go to its visible length option in the properties window, and open the key editor. Set a key point at the moment when the first tracking point's duration on the timeline ends, using the time cursor for precision. Repeat these steps for each curved line so that they're synchronized with their corresponding tracking points to complete the effect. For the second animation, we need to select an effect in the conversion settings. Let's choose Lens Flare. This will create lens flare effects within the text layer, with tracking points embedded inside each of them. Next, select all lens flare objects on the timeline and adjust the necessary parameters in the properties window to achieve the desired look. You can set the settings the same way we do. The last conversion mode is text blocks. Before converting, enable the Set the Optimal Size option in the Properties window. Now proceed with the conversion. As you see, the settings for this mode are similar to those for free shapes. Let's set the Split by parameter to words. This will place each word of the text on a separate layer. You can also add transitions and effects using other options in the settings window, just as we did with the free shapes. We want to show you how to create an animation of word swapping. To do this, select all the converted objects on the timeline and set the indent first line parameter on the ribbon to 0. Adjust the position of each text object on the timeline so that each one disappears before the next one appears. And that's it! Look at the result! And there you have it! By combining different conversion modes, you can create unique, eye-catching animations. Do not hesitate to try out various settings for more creative possibilities. For a deeper dive, check out our how-to article linked in the description. With a bit of practice, you can make dynamic text animations in no time. Thanks for watching, and we wish you happy editing! Bye!